Hi guys, so today I'll be discussing with you the next section for paper 1 question 150 question series. So today is day 4 and the section which I'll be discussing is communication, and the questions that follows will be from question number 16 to question number 20. Subscribe our channel for more informational videos, and that will definitely benefit you for your further exam. And do message us on Telegram group for further queries. So the communication section is really easy. You just need to build some understanding on this topic. So starting with this question number 16, a disruption in the communication process is called. So a disruption in the communication should be easy. It should flow from the sender to the receiver without any disruption, so that the intent of the message is maintained in the communication while communicating from the sender to receiver. So transgression is basically a lawful offense. So this is not the answer. Feedback. Now after receiving the information, the receiver gives the feedback to the sender. So this is also not the disruption in the communication process. So what communication process is? Sender have a message, he encodes it, he sends the message across to the receiver, receiver decodes the message, and the receiver then finally gives the feedback to the sender. Noise is definitely a disruption in communication process, because noise distorts the intent of the message, and that might also bring in the barriers of communication, because the receiver could understand anything else. The intent of the message that the receiver is understanding and the intent of the message that the sender wanted to communicate might be different because of the noise there in the communication process. And interaction is basically, by interaction, the communication is there. Communication is happening because of the interaction between the sender and the receiver. So noise is the correct answer here. Then we have question number 17. Assertion: the initial messages to students in the classroom by a teacher need not be critical to establish interactions later. So what this assertion means is, the assertion is saying that the initial messages, so supposedly if you are going to a class and the teacher on the first day thinks that the initial communication between her and between the students does not really matter. But this is not true, because the first day interactions builds the rapport of the teacher, and that builds the communication process easier in the further days. So that is basically critical, that is important in the initial days for interacting in the later stage. So reason given is, more control over communication process means more control over what the students are learning. So yes, if you bars the students from communicating through each other, communicating between them, so that will definitely means that you are controlling the students over their ideas, over their communication process, and that will definitely hinder the learning of the students. So basically assertion is wrong and the reasoning is true. I have already explained to you, because the initial messages to the students in the classroom by a teacher is critical, is important for interactions later, and the reasoning here is correct, because the communication process means more control over the students, and that will definitely affect the learning of the students. Now we have question number 18. When we try to organize details in our mind, we are seeking to. So when we organize the details in our mind, when we are thinking about something and we are organizing the details in our mind, so we have a complex idea there. We have a complex structured idea, and from the complex structured idea, then we categorize it in the easiest task, the difficult task, or the most difficult task, and then we plan according to it. So basically we have a process of complex information running in our head, and then we try to categorize it, we try to simplify it for our understanding. So option number 2 is the correct answer. Then we have question number 19. What is effective listening? So effective listening, what does effective listening means? Effective listening is basically a receiver understands the intent of the message that was supposed to be communicated by the sender in the exact same way. So the intent of the message understood and the intent of the message that is sent across should be the same. And for that, the listener should listen properly. He should clarify the things. He should not attach the subjective meanings to the messages. He should not run his own mind and then attach subjective meanings without clarification from the sender. He should not do the detailed analysis before listening to anything. He should not filter out the points of disagreement, because that will basically results in the selective attention of the listener. So basically, after listening the message, confirming the understanding of a message from the sender is really important for effective listening. So option number 4 is the correct answer. Then we have, which of the following is not a successful communication? So a successful communication means a communicator has build good communication skills. He could express his ideas through words, through in-verbal communication, non-verbal communication easily. So he should try to present the material in a precise way. He should try to send across the message in a simplified, lucid language. So one who presents material in a precise and clear way is a part of successful communication. One who is able to adopt himself according to the language of the communicator. For example, if you understand English, so I am trying to communicate the entire thing in English for better understanding, for your better understanding, and to keep intact the intent of the message that I am communicating. So this is also a successful communication. Fourth one who sometimes become informal before the receiver and develops the rapport. This is also correct. So one who knows a lot but somewhat reserved in his attitude. So an introvert person might feel difficulty while communicating because he cannot express his ideas in words easily, and he is not able to communicate the intent of the message that he tries to send. So option number 3 is the correct answer, because this is not a successful communication. So let me tell you, this entire section is really easy. All you need to do is understand the concept of communication, that how does it work, what are the barriers of communication, what is the process of communication. So you will definitely excel in this section. Now do subscribe to our channel for more informational videos, and for further queries or send message to our Telegram group. Thank you.